Good morning, students. Welcome back to another lecture from the course System Modeling and Simulation. In this lecture, I am going to discuss about keeping models, which is a module 2 from the syllabus. The contents of this module are as follows. First content being is the characteristics of keeping system. The second one is keeping notation. Third one is long run measures of performance of keeping systems. Fourth is steady state behavior of infinite population Markovian model. The fifth one is steady state behavior of finite population models. And the last topic is network of queues. Now let us start from the first topic, that is the characteristics of queuing system. This is actually the repetition of the first module, which we already studied. The first key element from the queuing system is customer. So we know that customer is anything which requests for service. The customer can be a person, a machine, a truck, a mechanic, patient, anything which requires some facility, some service, right? Similarly, the server might be anything which serves the customer, right? So server might refer to any receptionist or repair person, CPU, any computer or washing machine, any source, any resource which provides some service, requested service. Example, if you take a reception desk as a system, so the people who are arriving at the reception desk can be said as customers, and similarly the receptionist who is serving the people can be said as what? The server. Similarly, there are a lot of examples we can give. If you take hospital, the patients coming at the hospital, in the hospital, can be taken as considered as customers, whereas the nurses can be, or nurses or doctors can be considered as servers. So there are a lot of examples for the queuing system in this regard. The third characteristic in the queuing system is the calling population. We already know this is a repetition. This is the terminology is what we have already studied from the first module. The calling population is nothing but the population of potential customers, right? It can be a finite or it can be infinite. For example, if you take a bank system, the customers arriving in the bank can be called as what? The calling population. How many customers will arrive? It can be finite or infinite, right? So similarly, system capacity refers to the number of customers that may be waiting in the line or the system, both. It is a combination of both. That means what? The customers in the system or as well as the customers in the waiting line or in the queue. The next being is the arrival process. We already know when we are simulating the system, so the customers arriving in the system, to simulate the arrival process, we normally take inter-arrival times, right? And that too we take that as random numbers. So arrival process of finite population models is usually characterized in terms of inter-arrival times of successive customers. So inter-arrival time, you know, it's a time between arrival of the nth customer to the time from the next customer, that is n plus 1 customer. Queue behavior. Queue behavior refers to the customer's action while waiting in the queue for service to begin, right? So when the customers are waiting in the queue, what type of action they take, what type of behavior, that is called as what? Queue behavior. Sometimes in most of the situations there are different queue behavior, such as balk. So the customer when he sees the line that is too long, he will leave the queue. This is referred to as the balk. Renage, so after seeing the line is moving too slowly, the customer will leave the line, right? After waiting for some times, the line is moving too slowly, then the customer will leave. This is what is what renage. Jockey, when the customer sees one line is moving slowly and another line is moving faster, then what he will do? He will move from this line to another line. This is called as what? Jockey. Similarly, the next one, the queue discipline. So queue discipline is nothing but the logical ordering of customers in the queue, and it determines which customer will be chosen for the service when the server becomes free, right? The common queue disciplines are first in, first out, last in, first out, and zero, that is a service in random order, SPT, that is the shortest processing time first, service according to priority. Okay, let us see the eighth subtopic from this. So that is the service time and service mechanism. Once the customers arrive in the system and waiting in the queue or the system, So how the service has to be provided, right? So for example, now if you see the service times and of the successive arrivals are denoted, let us denote the service times required by the different customers is S1, S2, S3 and so on, right? There may be constant or a random distribution. The queue system consists of the number of service centers and interconnecting queues. Each service center consists of some number of servers working in parallel. That is, upon getting to the head of the line, the customer takes the first available server. Here, I mean to say that there are a lot of servers. That means what, if you go to a bank system, there will be a lot of desks, or there will be a lot of clerks. Minimum 2 to 3 clerks will be there where the customers can go and get their service. So that we are calling it as number of servers that are in parallel. Let us see, for example, if you say the server is one, single server is there, then we represent C is equal to 1. C represents the number of servers here in the notation of the queue. And multiple servers are there. How many servers? The server will be like from 1 to infinity, 1 to less than infinity. Or unlimited servers means what? We don't know what that is. The C is equal to infinity. Right? So this is just an example of how we denote the service times and service mechanism. Here I have discussed about the service times being represented using S1, S2, S3 and the number of servers being S1, S2, S3 or infinite servers, whatever it is. It depends upon the situation. So now if you consider a discount warehouse where the customers may either serve themselves or wait for 3 clerks and finally leave after paying the single cashier, right? So this is a system where three clerks are there. The customers will serve themselves or they will wait for one of the clerk to be serving them. So for example, these arrivals, these are the customers are arriving in the system. So as I said, there are three queues, three clerks. So two clerks service center 1 and service center 2. At service center 1, self-service, that means what, the customers are serving themselves. So how many customers, we will take it as infinity. As the server, as the customers are infinity, as they are serving themselves, the servers are also infinity because they are self-servicing. The number of customers here is equal to the number of servers. Therefore, C is equal to infinity. Small c here represents the number of servers. So here, how many customers coming, that many servers we can say. That's why it is infinity. So in the second queue, there is a service center 2 where 3 clerks are there. Either they can serve themselves, the example what I have taken, or they can wait for any one of the clerk out of the 3 clerks to serve themselves. So this is a queue 2 where 3 clerks are there to serve themselves. That's why C is equal to 3 article. That is, the servers are 3 here. So after getting served themselves or served by any one of the customers in queue 2, they will move to the next counter, which is a single counter to pay the cash. Again, they have to stand in queue. So that is C is equal to 1 because there is only one cashier here, according to my example. And after paying the cash, they will depart. This is just a representation of the service times and the number of servers, how they are serving for the example what I have discussed. So discount warehouse with 3 service centers here, right? So as I said already, there are 3 clerks here in the service center 2. So the internal representation of this is shown below. The subsystem consisting of Q2, that is this queue, and service center 2 is shown in more detail. So as I said, there are 3 clerks, that's why the 3 servers, customers will arrive and they will depart from this after getting served. This is just the detailed representation of this diagram, right? So let us see another example. A candy manufacturer has a production line which consists of 3 machines separated by inventory in process buffers. The machine makes and wraps the individual pieces of candy. The first machine makes and wraps the individual pieces. The first machine, that is a machine 1, what it does? It makes and wraps the individual pieces of candies. Whereas the second machine, it packs 50 pieces, right? This is for packing, this is for making and wrapping the candies. And the third machine seals the wrap and seals and wraps the box, right? So there are 3 machines where the first machine makes and wraps the individual pieces of candies. The second machine packs the candies, that are 50 pieces max. And next is what, the third machine, which seals and wraps the box. The 2 inventory buffers have the capacity. The first inventory buffer has the capacity of 1000 boxes each. Sorry, first and second, both. Both the machines have, what is the capacity? 1000, right? And this is illustrated in the diagram below, the candy production line. This is just to show how the services are provided, right? So in the this Q1 refers to what the raw material for which is for producing the candies and packing the candy, they're wrapping the individual pieces of candies by this machine 1. So when the raw material comes for packing and wrapping of the individual machines, individual candies, after doing that it goes to Q2. What does the second machine does? The second machine packs the pieces in the box. The maximum capacity of the queuing is, as I have mentioned, is 1000 boxes. This is the packer. And after packing is done, then we need to go for sealing and wrapping. So that will be done by the third machine. This is just a diagrammatic representation of how the service is provided in queue. You can see the system is modeled having three service centers. In each service center, there is only one server because there is only one machine in each service center. That's why C is equal to 1. This is important just to know the notation. I have discussed here. C is equal to 1 because in each service system, there is only one machine, right? Because of the queue capacity constraints, machine 1 shuts down whenever the inventory buffer fills up to capacity. Yes, whenever the machine buffer fills up to capacity, the machine 1 shuts down. That means what? Once this is full, the machine 1 is off. And while the machine 2 shuts down whenever the buffer empties. Whenever the buffer is empty, the machine 2 is shut down. In brief, the system consists of a single server queues in series, right? These are the single server queues. How they are connected? They are connected in series, right? With queue capacity constraints and continuous arrival stream at the first queue. So after completing the first topic, the first topic being what we have seen now is the characteristics of queuing system. In this, we have seen key elements of the queuing system such as customer, server, calling population, arrival process, queue behavior, queue discipline, service times and service mechanisms with some examples. So next we will see the second topic from this chapter. So before going to the second, let us see the second topic, queuing notation. This system is proposed by Kendall. It's a national system for parallel server systems, which is widely adopted, which is based on the formatter shown below. That is A/B/c/n/k. These letters represent some of the characteristics of the system, such as A represents the inter-arrival time distribution, B represents the service time distribution, small c represents the number of parallel servers in the system, and n represents the system capacity, k represents the size of the calling population. System capacity here means the number of people in the system as well as in the queue. And the calling population, we know it's a population of the potential customers, normally taken as infinity most of the times. Sometimes it is within the finite range, right? For example, if you see this, m/m/1/infinity. That means here there are five symbols. So first m stands for A. The second m stands for B. 1 is nothing but here C. N is nothing but infinity. And K is nothing but infinity here in the example, which indicates what? Well, as I already said, A represents inter-arrival time distribution. Here, M stands for inter-arrival time distribution. That is, inter-arrival time distribution is represented as M. And B, as I said already, that is the service time. That is, B is represented, the service time is represented as M here. And C, I said already, it is the number of parallel servers. C is equal to 1. That means what? There is only one server in the system, which I have said in the example. N is nothing but the system capacity, the number of people in the system. That is infinity here. And K is the size of the calling population, that is, which is also infinity. That means what? The size of the calling population is also infinity in this example, right? So as I said, you see the above description I have given indicates a single server. So I didn't start with M and M. I started my description with 1. That is what single server having an unlimited capacity. You see here, this is infinity, unlimited capacity and infinite population. This is the third one. So M and M, I am not specifying here while telling. I'm starting the thing with this one, third bit, fourth and fifth. One server, infinite queuing capacity, that is a system capacity. Here I have mentioned it as unlimited queuing capacity. It should be actually speaking, it is unlimited system capacity, right? And infinity, last infinity, it was what? Infinite people, that is a infinite population of potential arrivals, right? There is a note, when n and k, that is the last and last but one, that is this is n, this is k, are infinite when this is infinite and this is infinite, that is n and k are infinite. As I said, n and k is this one and k is this one. N represents system capacity and k represents the calling population. So when n and k are infinite, they may be dropped. That means what? Whenever this n and k are infinite, it's understood we can drop them. It's understood because normally we take the calling population, the system capacity as infinite. So the above example, we can rewrite it as in short format as one m slash m slash 1. I'm dropping that infinity infinity, right? So there are additional notations which are used for parallel server notations, which are listed below. Students, these are very important symbols we need to remember. From now onwards, only we will be dealing with this kind of symbols and formulas. So PN stands for steady state probability of having n customers in the system. That is the number of the, what is the probability that this n customers will be there in the system? That is a steady state probability. Pn of t represents the probability of n customers in the system at a particular time t. Lambda here refers to what? Arrival rate. Lambda is effective arrival rate. Mu refers to service rate of one server. That means what? How much time? Like what is the rate at which server serves the customers? Right? Rho here stands for server utilization or proportion of the time the server is busy out of the total time. An stands for inter-arrival time between customers n minus 1 and n. That is the time between arrival of n minus 1 customer and the nth customer. Sn stands for service time of the nth arrival customer. Wn, as W indicates for waiting, total time spent in the system by nth customer arriving, nth arriving customer. So Wn of Q, that is total time spent by the customer in the waiting line, right? Which customer? The nth customer. L of T, that is the number of customer. L, normally remember L means number here. In the notation, L stands for what? Number. L of T is the number of customers in the system at time T. LQ of T, number of customers in Q at time T. L, long run time average number of customers in the system. LT, LQ, long run time average number of customers in the queue. W, long run average time spent in system per customer. WQ, long run average time spent in queue per customer. So whenever W is coming, you can see I have bolded that. So whenever W is coming, it is time. Whenever L is coming, it is number. Are you getting me? Wherever W is there, it is time. Wherever L is there, it's a number. And it depends upon the suffix and the prefix what it is exactly. So just you can, to remember these symbols, we can say that L refers to what? A number, and W refers to time, so that it becomes easy for you to remember the symbols. So let us move forward. The third topic, that is 6.3, long run measures of performance of queuing system. Like if you want to know how the queuing system performs, what are the measures, that's a long run measure, so it is taken for a longer period of time, so that we can identify what are the measures the system will follow while we are implementing, while we are modulating the queuing systems with the different processors and the different servers. So let us see the 6.3. These are very important topics, most probably asked in exams. So the primary long run measures of queuing systems are as I already said, L means time, a long run time average number of customers in the system. That is what? This is the number of customers, average number of customers for that period of time in the system. LQ, long run time average number of customers in queue. W, long run time average time spent in the system per customer. WQ, long run average time spent in the queue per customer. So whenever queue is there, it is refers to queue. If queue is not there, it is generally taken as a system, right? If it is queue, it is only at the particular queue, whatever you're speaking. And the row always here, we are indicating it is a server utilization or the time for which the server is busy. This important note is there, you need to remember when they are asking the problems, you have to remember this. Whenever the term system refers, it refers to both the combination of queue as well as the service mechanism. That is what? The waiting line as well as what? At the server. Right? Both. That is the general meaning of system. If I say only queue, that is only refers to queue. If I say system, we should understand that it is referring to both the number of people in the system as well as in the queue. So let us see the first long run average parameters, long run measures. First long run measure is the time average number in the system. First is what? The time average number in the system. So it is done, it is denoted by L. Yeah, time average number. So the time weighted average number in the system is defined by L cap, which is equal to 1 by T summation of I from 0 to infinity I into Ti, which can be written as which can be written as I from 0 to infinity I into Ti by T. So what is this? We need to remember this parameter. This is defined. These are some characteristics which we need to remember for the system. So what is this? The time average number, time average number in the system is given by L cap is equal to summation from I is equal to 0 to infinity I into Ti by T. So if I solve the problem, if I solve the problem, you will exactly remember what the formula is, how the formula is. So in this module, there are a lot of formulas to be remembered. So there is one example here. Consider the queuing system Consider the queuing system over a period of T. So the time period of the queuing system is capital T for the simulation shown in the figure below. So he has shown some graph for the simulation over a time T. From this, he will ask some parameters to be calculated. We should carefully observe. So what is the time period? The time period is from 0 to capital T. Capital T is what? 20. 20 time units, either it's a seconds, minutes or hours, whatever it is, it's time units. So during this, there is L of T plotted. So T and L of T. What is L of T? Just now I said L cap is, what is this? Time weighted average number of number in the system, right? So let us see how it has like, what is the diagram? Carefully observe. So 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 3, 5 odds we are not specified. We specify 0, 2, 4, 6 here. So it is understood here, it is 1, it is 3, here 5. So if you see the system, from 0 to 2, it is a T1. From 2 to 3, it is T0. Again, from 3 to 5, it is T1. Again, from 5 to 7, it is T2. Similarly, from 7 to 8, it is T3. From 8 to 10, it is T2. From 10 to 12, it is T1, if you see the graph. And from 14 to 16, it is T0. From 16 to 20, it is T1. So this is the number of system, that is LT at time T. Number in the system. How many people are there in the system? How many customers are in the system? That is LT at time T. So now the question will be, he will be giving this graph, or he will give the system from 0 to this is this T, directly T1, T2, he must specify. So what he's asking? He's asking is to find L or L cap. Both are same here. That is what he's asking you to find, that time weighted average number. So how to find the time weighted average number from this diagram? What the formula we know? We know the formula is this one. That is what? I. Summation of I from 0 to infinity, from I into Ti by T. What is I? I we have here, I think so, T1, T0, T1, T2, T3. So that means what? 0 to 3. I value ranges from 0 to 3. You can see here, T0, T1, T2, T3, T2, T1, T0, T1. That means what? I value ranges from 0 to infinity. That means what? Infinity value in this diagram will replace from I is equal to 0 to 3 actually, because T3 is a max here, right? And I, when I is equal to 0, what is T0 value? Divided by total time T. Total time T is 20, because the time period given is 20. So the total time T is 20, we know. We need to find each, for I is equal to 0, what is Ti? For I is equal to 1, what is T1? For I is equal to 2, what is T2? For I is equal to 3, what is T3? So how to find that? It is very simple from the diagram. So what is the total I value is equal to 0? What is the T0? So how many T0s we have here? From 2 to 3. This is 1. 2 to 3 is 1 unit. So similarly, T0 is here also. That is what? From 14 to 16, 2 units. So here 1 unit plus 2 units. Totally T0 will be 3 units. So that's what I am writing. Let us denote Ti as a total time from 0 to 2. So in the given figure, it is seen that T0 is equal to 3. How this is 3? Here 1 plus here 2 units. That is T0 is equal to 3. Similarly, how much is T1? T1 is from 0 to 3, it will become 2. 2 from, again here, from 3 to 5, it will become 2. 2 plus 2 is 4. Somewhere else, yeah, here also T1 is there after 4. 10 to 4, it will become 4. 4 plus 4 is 8. 4 plus 4 is 8. And again, T1 is here also from 16 to 20, again 4. 4 plus 4, 8. 8 plus 4, 12. So therefore, I have written T1 is equal to 4. Sorry, T1 is equal to 12. Similarly, T2,
what are the values of the units of T2 from 3 to 5, 2 units, and again from here, from 8 to 10, another 2 units, 2 plus 2, 4, so therefore T2 is equal to 4 I have done. T3, so T3 is here from what is that, 7 to 8, that is only 1 unit, so T3 is equal to 1. So I have written each value of that is a T0, T1, T2, T3. Why I have written only up to T3? Because only T3s are there. That means what, I ranges from 0 to 3 and individual values of T0 I have calculated. Now we will substitute this formula in the formula what we have discussed here. It's very simple. I is equal to 0 to infinity, I into Ti by Ta. So simple. I is equal to, as I said, I ranges from 0 to 3 here. Can put that. So first I value is 0. When I value is 0, what is T0? It is 3. 0 into 3. Plus, when I value is 1, what is T1 value? 12. 1 into 12. Plus, when I value is 2, what is T2 value? 4. 2 into 4. Right? Because I ranges from 0 to infinity. 0, 1, 2, 3. Right? When I value is 3, what is T3 value? 1. So, just we substituted. And total time T is what? 20. 0 to 20 is a time period. So, we'll get 23 by 2. So, that is equal to 1.15 customers. Don't think that customers is a number, like a person. It can be 1% or 2% or 3%. How it can be 1.15 customers? We cannot have 1.15 customers. But because this is an time average number, so decimal points will get. It doesn't mean that it is a physical entity like a person. 1% should be there, 2%. Don't round it off to 1% or 2%. It is 1.15 customers. That means what? This is the average number of customers in the system over a period of time from 0 to 20. Let us see another example, another long run measure. After completing time average number, that which is the first long run measure. So let us see the second average, second long run measure, that is average time spent in the system per customer. This indicates what is the average time each customer is spending in the system. So the average time spent in the system per customer is given by W cap is equal to 1 by N, where N is the number of customers. So from 1 to N, the customers raise 1, and WI. So WI is that when I is equal to 1, W refers to the time average, time spent by the first customer. When I is equal to 2, W2 will refer to the time spent by the second customer. So, let us take the same example, same diagram. Actually, in the exam, he will ask, after giving this diagram, he will ask all the three which I am going to discuss, but I have taken it as separately here. So, consider the queuing system, same thing again, over a period of time t equal to 20, for the simulation shown below. Find the average time spent in the system per customer. So the average time spent in the system per customer is given by W cap. We know this formula. Just we need to put that. And remember, it's one important point here. To find the average time spent in the system per customer, we know the formula, that is W cap is equal to 1 by N, I is equal to 1 to N WI. So here, carefully listen, he is asking you to find the average time spent in the system per customer. To do this, we should very easily, we should remember one important point. What is the important point is here, I have written it as a note, each jump upwards, each upward in the diagram, when there is upward jump, actually there is no arrow mark, but when it goes upwards, the graph goes upwards, that I am calling it as upward jump. Each upward jump represents here arrival in the diagram. Whereas each downward jump represents a departure. That is very important. If you know, then only you can solve this problem. Each upward jump, the graph going upwards is nothing but arrival. If the graph comes downwards, it is departure. Right? So now I have written it. Note, each jump upwards represents an arrival. Each jump downwards represents a departure. Assuming that the system has a single server and a FIFO queue discipline, which he has not given, we should assume that it is having only one server. So from this figure, upward jumps, where the upward, at zero, it is going up. The graph is starting from here. That means what? At zero, it is upward jump, right? So at zero, upward jump is there. So next, it comes down here. So we are writing upward jump. So now again at three, upward jump, right? Now similarly, again at five, upward jump. Again at seven, from here, it goes up. So from here it is going up, so it is also upward jump. This is stationary, not a problem, right? Now again, when it comes here, it is downwards jump. It is also downward. Again here it's upward. When it comes here, from here to here it is stationary, but here it goes up, right? At 16 also upward jump. This is stationary. Again, this is a downward jump. So similarly, departures are what? At downward jump. So this is arrival because it's upward jump. This is stationary. Now this is, it has to come down. The diagram has come down here. That means what, it's a departure. So say I have written departures occur at 2. Similarly, this goes upward, arrival, nothing, again arrival, nothing, again arrival, nothing, again comes down. You see here, when this line comes down here, from this point it is not going up, it is coming down. That means what, it is departure here. So what is the time at which it is departing? 8. So therefore the second departure is 8. Similarly, here it is coming down at time t, so at 10, so departure, third departure is 10. Similarly, here it comes down, the departure is at 14, and next it comes, it goes up, arrival, stationary, again it comes down, it is departure. So arrivals are at 0, 3, 5, 7, and 16, whereas departures are at 2, 8, 10, 14, and 20. Right? Writing this is very important to calculate the time, to calculate the time spent in the system per customer. So the first customer spends, when it arrives, what is the first arrival? Arrival is at, when is the first arrival? It is at 0 because upward jump. When is the first departure? It is at 2. That is what, departure minus arrival, 2 minus 0 is 2. This is the time spent by the first customer in the system. You can see here, the first arrival is at 0, departure is at 2. 2 minus 0 is what? 2. When is the second arrival? Second arrival is at this time, 3. And when it departs, when is the next departure? Not this, here. The departure, next departure is here, at this point, at this point. What is that point? That is 8. That is the second departure is 8. 8 minus 3 is 5. Similarly, for the third customer, when is the next arrival? Very important, at 10. You can see the next arrival is at 10. Sorry, the next arrival is at 5. 5, and when is the departure at 10? So 10 minus 5 is equal to 5. 10 minus 5 is equal to 5, which is equal to 5. So similarly, the next fourth, for the fourth customer, departure is at 14 and the arrival is at 7. So 14 minus 7 is equal to 7. Similarly, for the fifth customer, the departure is at 20 and the arrival is at 16. 20 minus 16 is what? 4. So from this diagram, if you know upward jump represents arrival and downward jump represents departure, then only you can write departure minus arrival. This is what? Departure minus arrival. First departure minus first arrival is the time spent by the first customer. Second departure minus second arrival is the time spent by the second customer. Third departure minus third arrival is the time spent by the third customer. Fourth departure minus fourth arrival is nothing but the time spent by the fourth customer. Fifth departure minus fifth arrival is nothing but the time spent by the fourth customer. So we got time spent by each customer. There are 5 customers. We got so from the diagram, it is very much clear there are 5 customers. Even if it doesn't specify the number of customers are 5, from the diagram, we should understand that the number of customers here are 5. Because by seeing the arrivals and departures, we can very easily come to know there are 5 customers. So we got now arrival and departure of each customer. So what W cap indicates? Summation of all the time spent by each customer to get the average time. So we will add up all those things. So 2 plus 5 plus 5 plus 7 plus 4. This is 2 is our time spent by the first customer. 5 is the time spent by the second customer. 5 is the time spent by the third customer. 7 is the time units spent by the fourth customer. And 4 is the time units spent by the fifth customer. If you add up 23 and the total number of customers are 5. So that is 4.6 time units is the average time spent by each customer. Are you getting me? So what is the important point here? The important point here is upward jump represents arrival. Wherever it's stationary, it is nothing, it's a processing. But when it comes to downwards, it is nothing but it's a downward jump, that is a departure. Upward stationary, we have written it as a bold line, whereas arrival and departures, that is upward and downwards, we have represented as dotted lines. That is very much important. And there is one more law, called as conservation law, which says L cap is always is equal to lambda into W cap. Lambda is the arrival rate. Always this equation will be true. So if you want to verify this, arrival rate of the customer, 5 by 20. Why means, how it is 5 by 20 in this diagram? Because there are 5 customers and the total time period is what? 20. That is what? Arrival is nothing but the total number of customers divided by total time. 5 by 20, that is 1 by 4. Arrival rate is equal to 1 by 4. We have to remember this formula. Arrival rate lambda is equal to total number of customers arriving divided by the total time. 5 divided by 20, 20 is the total time. How 20 is the total time? Because from the diagram 0 to 20, total time is 20. So 20 is the total time. And how 5 customers? from this upwards and downwards jumps, we identified that there are 5 customers. So arrival rate lambda is nothing but the number of customers divided by total time. If you want, you can write it in the bracket. This is nothing but what total number of customers, total number of customers divided by total simulation time, which is equal to 5 by 20, that is equal to 1 by 4. So we got lambda is equal to 1 by 4. And L cap already we calculated here. L cap, how much we got? L cap is equal to 1.15. And W we calculated just now, that is 4.6. So conservation equation is this one. L into W cap, that is 4.1 into 1 by 4 into 4.6 is equal to 1.15. If you do this, both LHS and RHS will always be equal. Then only the conservation equation is verified. So normally in exam, he'll give this diagram and he'll ask all the three things which I have separated here. He will ask from the simulation system shown below, identify or find out that is L. L, what is L? Time weighted average number. And second thing, he will ask time spent per customer, that is W. And he will ask you to verify the conservation equation. All the three he will be giving in one problem most of the times. So let us see the next parameter, long run observation, that is server utilization. As the name itself is indicating, server utilization is defined as the proportion of the time that the server is busy. Out of the total time in the simulation, for how much time the server was busy, how much time it was serving the customer, that is nothing but the server utilization. We denote this with rho actually. Actually rho cap, so while we're writing, we'll tend it to rho. So observed server utilization is denoted by rho cap. And it is defined over a period of time from 0 to t, whatever the time period t is there. So long run server utilization is normally denoted by rho. For the system that exhibit long stability, rho cap is not, tend to what? Rho, as a t tends to infinity. Because it's a long run, time t is what? Infinity, rho cap tends to rho. So server utilization in one of the example of g/g/c/infinity/. As I said, this is a 5 character notation. Previously here we have taken m/m. And this is for B, this is for C, this is for N and K, already we have discussed. So G/G/, always 5 notation. So as I said, already we discussed, right? Let me show that. So this is the notation, A/B/C/N/K, right? So now if you compare, as I already said, A represents inter arrival time, B represents service time, C represents the number of servers in the parallel servers, and N represents system capacity, and K represents the calling population. So let us take a simple example. Don't need not worry, need not panic about what is this G/G/C and infinity. All the symbols refers to that A/B/C/N/K. So G/G/C/CQ. So let us see where C is nothing but the identical servers in parallel. If it is one, there is one server. If it is two, there are two parallel servers like that. And if the arriving customer finds more than one server idle, the customer chooses the server without favoring any yes. If C means what? Number of servers. If C is more than one, the arriving customer will choose any one of the server, right? Because both are idle at that time. If both are idle, any one of the server it will choose. And arrivals occur at a rate lambda from the calling population, and the server works at the rate mu. This is the working rate of the server, or the rate at which the server serves the customer is what? Mu. And the rate at which the customers arrive in the system is lambda. I have taken lambda is the rate at which the customers arrive. For example, for the time period, so many customers arrived. How I'll write that? I'll write it as lambda. And how fast the server is working, how fast the server is serving the customers who are arrived, that is I will take it as mu. In general, lambda is the arrival rate of the customer, mu is the service rate of the server, right? So based on this, the average number of busy servers is given by, out of the total servers, the average number of busy servers is given by LS is equal to lambda by mu, that is arrival rate divided by service rate, right? If the number of customers are 0 to less than C, right? And the long run server utilization is defined by rho. This is important. Rho is equal to LS by C, where what is LS? LS already said lambda by mu, right? Important thing, lambda by mu if I write, and C is multiplied here. Lambda divided by C mu. C is the number of, as I said already, C is the number of servers. Lambda is the arrival rate. arrival rate, lambda is the arrival rate, and mu is the service rate of the server, the rate at which the server serves the customer. And lambda is the arrival rate, the rate at which the customers arrives in the system. If you remember these two formulas, then you can very easily solve the problems which are quite often asked in the exam. What is that? Rho is equal to ls by c, that is nothing but lambda by c mu, where ls is nothing but lambda by mu, where l is nothing but the average number of busy servers, which is given by lambda by mu. If in the question he may ask, what is the time average number of the busy servers, we need to apply this formula and find out. He will ask the long run average servers utilization, you have to use this formula, right? The rho always ranges from 0 to 1 because it's a server utilization. So let us see one problem which uses these two formulas. You need to remember these two formulas for server utilization. Actually, the server utilization formula is rho is equal to lambda by c mu, which is nothing but ls by c. What is ls? Ls is nothing but lambda by mu. What is lambda? Lambda is the arrival rate, and what is mu? Mu is the server rate at which the server serves the customer. What is lambda? Lambda is the arrival rate at which the customers arrives in the system. Repeatedly I am telling. So let us see now one problem. Customers arrive at random to a license bureau. So whatever it is, a license bureau or any shop, whatever it is, we should bother about what is the given data, what is the arrival rate, what is the service rate, how many servers are there, and what is asking. We should remember the symbols, we should remember the formulas, then only we can solve the problem. We should read the question carefully. They are very simple questions. If you make mistake in reading and analyzing the question, then even if you know the formulas, you will not be able to apply it properly, right? So read it very carefully and slowly. What is that? Customers arrive at random to a license bureau at a rate of 50 customers per hour. Currently there are 20 clerks each serving 5 customers per hour on an average. So this sentence is given simple, but we need to find out what is lambda here, what is mu here, what is the number of servers, that is c here, lambda mu c. And what is asking? Find long run or steady state average utilization of the server. He is asking steady state average utilization of the server, or long run or steady state average utilization of the server. Already have said here, the average number of busy servers is given by this, and long run average server utilization is given by this. So the first point what is asking is long run or steady state server utilization. That means what the first point what is asking is this one, that is rho, lambda by c mu. And average number of busy servers already has said here, the second one is the first formula of the above. What is that? Average number of busy servers given by ls is equal to lambda mu. Second one is the first formula, and the first one is the second formula what is asking. Now for this, to solve this, I need to have second formula and I need to have first formula. What is there in that? Lambda, mu and c is there, correct? So we need to identify what is lambda, what is mu and what is c here. So let us read the question from the beginning. There are 20 clerks, right? Customers are arriving at random at a bureau at a rate of 50 per hour. That means what is the rate of arrival? 50 customers are arriving per hour. That means what? Lambda is equal to 50. That is the arrival rate, right? For arrival rate, we'll use lambda. And how many clerks are there to serve? That means what? How many servers are there to serve? There are 20 servers. That means what? The number of servers is what? 20. That is c is equal to 20. And each server is serving the customers at what rate? Each serving at 5 customers. That means what? Each server serves 5 customers in 1 hour. That means what? The service rate or the server rate is mu. That is equal to 5. So if you write this clearly by reading the question and writing the formula and substituting is very easy. If you have to understand what is lambda, what is c and what is mu. So let us see here. The first one what is asking is long run or steady state average utilization of the server, which is given by rho is equal to lambda by c mu. What is lambda? Lambda is equal to 50 divided by 20 into 5, because lambda is equal to 50, c is equal to 20 servers, and mu is equal to 5 average rate. So we will get 0.5. So server utilization is 50%. That means what? 50% of the times 50% efficient servers have been utilized. So average number of busy servers, how many servers are busy out of the 20 on an average? On an average. So that is given by lambda by mu, that is 50 by 5, that is 10. On an average out of the 20 servers, 10 servers are busy. Are you getting? So what is there here? The importance is what? We need to remember the symbol names. After reading the question, we should carefully write down what it indicates. Then we need to apply the formula. There is no other go. We need to remember this formula and substitute the values to get it. So that completes 6.3. So we'll move for the next topic, that is 6.4. I hope these questions and these problems are clear. So let us see about the 6.4. The 6.4 topic is a steady state behavior of infinite population Markovian models. The name itself is telling it is a steady state behavior. Here we will identify what are the steady state behavior of infinite population Markovian models. For the infinite population models, the arrivals are always assumed to be Poisson process. We already studied in the previous model Poisson process with the rate at arrival rate symbol is what lambda arrivals per unit. That is inter-arrival times are assumed to be, whenever I say Poisson process, we need to understand, as we have discussed already in the previous module, whenever I say Poisson process, we need to understand that the inter-arrival times are exponentially distributed, right? And the mean is always given by 1 by lambda. This is the point what we need to remember. Whenever you say it is a Poisson process of arrival rate or arrivals follow the Poisson process, suddenly one thing should come to your mind, that is what? The inter-arrival times are exponentially distributed and the mean is 1 by lambda. This should come. Whenever in the question or wherever in the case study he says Poisson process, arrivals are assumed to be Poisson process, we need to think, what we need to get is inter-arrivals are assumed to be exponentially distributed with mean is equal to 1 by lambda. That is the important thing whenever Poisson process is mentioned. And another thing, service times may be exponentially distributed. Whenever the service times are exponentially distributed, we write it as M for service times. As I said, ABC/NK, first A stands for arrival, inter-arrival, and B stands for service, C stands for number of servers, and N stands for system capacity, and K stands for the calling population. So whenever exponential distributed, we write M, or arbitrarily distributed, we write G. If it is exponentially distributed, we write M. If the service times are arbitrarily distributed, we write G in place of B. Right, we know A/B/C/N/K, right? And the Q discipline will be FIFO. Q discipline will be FIFO here in the Markovian model. Because of these exponential distribution assumptions on the arrival process, these models are called as what? Markovian models. Why these are called as Markovian models? And these models, we are assuming the distribution is what? Exponential. What distribution? Arrival time distribution, right? And even service times are also normally exponentially distributed. Sometimes it is arbitrarily, but we will think majorly it is as exponentially distributed. You see, arrivals are also exponentially distributed and service times are also exponentially distributed. Due to that, whenever Poisson process or exponential distribution is mentioned, we say that the model is Markovian model, right? So let us see the characteristics and we solve them problems based on this of the Markovian models, 6.4.1. So there will be a lot of formulas to remember here. If you don't remember these formulas, then you cannot solve anything. It is something like we should know these parameters. They have been defined, we should know it, right? These are the different parameters defined. So let us see single server queues with Poisson arrivals. Also, I said Poisson arrivals means what? Poisson arrival means whenever I say Poisson arrivals, inter-arrival times are exponentially distributed, service times are exponentially distributed. Then it is called Markovian models. So for the 6.4.1, I am taking single server queues with Poisson arrivals and unlimited capacity. And see, that's why I'm writing m slash g slash 1. Here, exponentially distributed m, service times are arbitrarily distributed, that's why it is g. If service times are also exponentially distributed, they will write m slash m here. Are you getting? Inter-arrival times, exponentially distributed, that's why m. Service time g means what? It is arbitrarily distributed, that's why it is g here, I have written. If suppose service time is also exponentially distributed, that here, instead of g, m will come here, right? One refers to the number of servers. So actually one, that means what here? C is equal to 1. That means what? There is only one server, single server queue. Now suppose the service time have the mean service time. Mean service time of the server is 1 by mu. And the variance, that is sigma square, is, and there is only one server in this problem. If that is the case, then rho is the server utilization we already know. Rho is nothing but lambda by mu will always be less than 1. Rho will always be less than 1. Then m slash g slash 1 q has a steady state probability distribution with steady state characteristics as given in the table. So this characteristic, that is a steady state characteristics of m slash g slash 1 system. Don't think that what is this m slash g slash 1? It is just a notation. M stands for exponential distribution of the service time. G stands for arbitrary distribution of the, m stands for exponential distribution of inter-arrival time. G stands for arbitrary distribution of service time. One stands for number of systems, one number of servers, there is one server. That is Markovian model, right? That's all. And with this parameter, that is a mean and variance, all those things. So these are the steady state parameters of m slash g slash 1, which we need to remember. So I have given notation as well as I have given the description what it stands for. Rho, already we know it's a server utilization, we have discussed. Rho is given by what? Lambda by mu, where rho is the service utilization and lambda is the arrival rate, mu is the service rate. L is equal to rho plus lambda square into 1 divided by mu square plus sigma square divided by 2 into 1 minus rho. Or it can also be given as rho plus rho square into 1 plus sigma square into mu square plus divided by 2 into 1 minus. So both the formulas are correct, both the formulas are equal. Whichever the parameters he has given in the question, depending upon the parameters, either we can use this formula or this formula. We have to use either this one depending upon the parameters given in the problem. There is no harm using this or that. Whichever the values you are available with, you can use either this one or that. So what is L here? L is the long run time, average number of customers in the system. And sigma is nothing but the mean service time. I'm not telling again here about rho and again or lambda, because rho and lambda already have defined here. Rho is the service time and lambda is the arrival rate and mu is the service rate. That I'm not writing repeatedly here. Whichever the new symbols are coming, only that I'm specifying here. And whichever I'm not specifying here, that means what they have already been said previously. So LQ is nothing but the long run time average number of customers in the queue, which is given by this formula or that one. Both are same. So whichever are given in the question, depending upon that, we can use any one and we can solve the problem. So what is LQ? LQ is called lambda square into 1 by mu square. This one I need to remove. Lambda square into 1 by mu square plus sigma square divided by 2 into 1 minus rho. And or this is also equal to rho square 1 plus sigma square into mu square divided by 2 into 1 minus rho. Similarly, what is W? These all parameters, these all formulas, these all equations we need to remember. There is no other option. W is the long run average time spent in the system per customer, which is given by this formula 1 by mu plus lambda into 1 divided by mu square plus sigma square divided by 2 into 1 minus rho. Similarly, WQ is the long run average time spent in the queue per system. I'm not describing here again one more time the symbols, because already I have specified what is lambda, what is mu, what is sigma, what is L, what is all those things I have specified. So whichever is not specified, that only I'm telling what is that symbol stands for here. Similarly, P0 is a steady state probability of the customer in the system, which is given by 1 minus rho. So these are the parameters, the steady state parameters of M slash G slash 1, which we need to remember. Remember one more note, because this will be helpful in the problem. Whenever only the mean and variance of the service times mean and variance are given, at that time we have to think that M slash G slash 1 is the appropriate model. M slash G slash 1 is appropriate. That means what? Arbitrarily distribution of inter-arrival time and, sorry, exponentially distribution of inter-arrival time and arbitrary distribution of service time, and there is only one server. That will be the better model whenever mean and variance are given, right? So let us solve one problem. So to solve the problems, we need to remember the meaning and equation, these equations for M slash G slash 1. There is one server and exponential distribution of inter-arrival and arbitrary distribution of service time. Apart from that, we need to remember all these formulas to solve the problem. These formulas are must and go. If you don't remember this, if you don't know this, then you cannot solve the problems. So let us see a simple problem here. This problem has been asked many times. So let us see in detail how to solve this problem. Listen carefully. Customers arrive at a walking shoe repair, whatever it is, walking shoe repair or some whatever the name of the shop he gives, we are least bothered about. We are bothered about what is the arrival rate, how many systems are there, how many servers are there, what is the service rate, what type of the model we should apply. By reading the question, by seeing the question thoroughly, we should decide all those things. What is given, we should write it carefully, we should read. If you understand, analyze, then only we can apply the formulas, right? So the arrival is at random, he says, first one. Okay, it is assumed that the arrivals occur at Poisson process. See, this is important. He's telling Poisson process. Just now I discussed, whenever the Poisson process is there, then it is assumed that M slash G slash 1, that is, inter-arrival are at exponential, inter-arrival are taking place at exponential, this one, what is this? Inter-arrivals are taking place in terms of exponential distribution, and well as service times are taken place by arbitrary distribution, right? So that's what he's telling Poisson process. Instead of telling inter-arrivals exponential distribution and service rate is arbitrary distribution, instead of that, he's only using the word Poisson process. At a rate 1.5 per hour, that means what? Arrival occur at a rate 1.5 per hour. Arrival rate he has given, that is lambda he has given. So directly after reading the question up to this sentence, I will write down arrival rate lambda is equal to 1.5 customers per hour. This is Poisson process, right? Next, I will continue here. Observations over several months have found that the shoe repair times by a single server, single worker is nothing but a single server. That means what? C is equal to 1. By seeing up to this, after reading up to this, I will write down C is equal to 1 because it's a single server or single worker. That is one. That means what? There is only one server in the system, right? And take an average of 30 minutes with standard deviation. That means the single worker is taking 30 minutes on an average to repair the shoe. Correct or not? That means what average service rate he is telling. 30 minutes. After reading up to this, I will write down average service rate of one server is equal to 30 minutes because he is telling him 30 minutes is the average time taken by one server. That is the mean service time is what? 30 minutes. Right? 30 minutes is the mean service time. That is how I write symbolically. 1 by mu is equal to half hour. That means what? 30 minutes means what? A server is taking 30 minutes to serve one customer. Is it right? Very carefully. You have to analyze very carefully. 30 minutes a server is taking means what? It is taking 30 minutes to serve one customer. That means what? In 1 hour, how many customers you will serve? 2 customers. Common sense. Are you following me? Are you getting 1 by mu is what? Half. That means what? In 30 minutes, he is serving one customer. So 1 by mu is what? Half hour. I converted the 30 minutes into hours 30. That means what? Mu is equal to 2. Can you tell me why it is 2? Because 30 minutes is the service rate. That means what? For every 30 minutes, he is serving one customer. Definitely for 1 hour, he will be serving. 1 hour is nothing but double. 30 plus 30. In 1 hour, he will be serving 2 customers per hour. So mu is equal to 2 per customer per hour. This is important. After reading up to this, writing, analyzing and writing that what is mu is very important. And standard deviation, let me continue the question. Standard deviation of 20 minutes. He is telling standard deviation is 20 minutes directly. Therefore, when the standard deviation is 20, then the variance is given by mu square, that is equal to 20 square into minute. That is 20 square divided by 60 square. Why I have done this 60 hours means already I have converted the things into hours because the arrival rate is given in hours. I have converted mu also. All the things, all the variables should be in one unit. So I am converting to the hours, not in minutes, because this is given in hours and this is also I converted to hours. Now this is 20 minutes has given. I am converting that minutes into hours. 20 minutes, how it will be? It is 6 divided by 60 hours. 60 square. Because this is a variance. That is a square. That is 20 square divided by 60 square. So that will be r square, that is 1 by 9 r square. Variance is equal to 1 by 9 r square. That is very important because I am converting minutes to hours. While converting minutes to hours, we need to divide by 60. So as it's a square, I am squaring both things. So I will be getting 1 by 9 per r square, right? So now, what is the first thing he is asking? Up to this, whatever the things he has given, I have written down all the things. Now, let us see what he is asking. He is asking us to identify the appropriate queuing model. So as I said already, after writing down up to this, I can very easily say the queuing model should be 1/m/g/1. Can you tell me why? Why m is? Because he is telling that Poisson process. Correct. When Poisson process arrival rate, the inter-arrival distribution, what I will be using m, Markovian model. And there is only one server, c is equal to 1. And g is what? Arbitrary distribution. Right. So that's why it is 1/g/1. And I have already given a note. Whenever mean and variance are given, so here in this question, mean and variance are given, correct? Whenever, that's why the note will come into picture here also. The note is also coming into picture to decide which is appropriate model. So remember, whenever mean and variance are given, so the appropriate model is m/g/1. So as in this question, mean and variance of the things are given, that's why the appropriate model is m/g/1. And one more thing, there is only one server and Poisson process is there. That's why we can decide. Right, so I am telling here the appropriate model is m/g/1 since only mean and variance are known. Right, and the second point is find the proportion of the time the worker is busy. That means what? The total time the worker is busy. The proportion of time the worker is busy, that is the server is busy, is given by, we know rho is equal to lambda by mu. Lambda we have directly in terms of r, mu also we converted in terms of r, 1.5 divided by 2. That is what? 0.75. This is the proportion of time the server is busy. Now the third thing what he is asking is, the third one he is asking is steady state time, average number of customers in the shop. What is the average number of customers for a particular time? That is given, we know that L is equal to, there are formulas here, already I said L, there are two formulas. So depending upon what is available with us, we can use either this formula or that formula. So I have used this, L is equal to rho plus lambda is equal, because we know lambda, we know mu and we know rho. So all the parameters we know. So I am using this, just I am substituting whatever I have got, which I have calculated above, So I'll get L is equal to 2.375 customers. Again, don't think that how can be the customers can be 2.3 customers. It's an average number, so we'll get in decimal. Doesn't mean that 2.3 persons are there, no. On an average, this many customers will be there, or this many people will be there in the shop. So this completes the problem based on M/G/1 from 6.4.1, that is a single server queues with poison arrival. This question is important. I hope you have followed this. So we'll see the next problem. Now, the second similar problem.
Let us see the second problem. It states like this. Consider a candy factory for making a candy at rate lambda is equal to 1.5 per hour. Observation over several months has found by the single machine, its mean service time sigma is equal to half hour, that is 1 by 2 per hour, and service rate is mu is equal to 2. We need to compute three things. Compute long run time average number of customers in the system, long run time average number of customers in the queue, and long run time spent in the queue per system. Long run average time spent in queue per customer. So as I already said, whenever the mean is given, we need to use the above formulas. As I said in the note, which is here, whenever the mean and variance of service times are given, we need to use M/G/1Q, which is appropriate model. Okay, he's asking three things. The same formulas will apply. He has given arrival rate is equal to 1.15 per customer. That is a Poisson process. Single machine, therefore, C is equal to 1. Service rate, mu is equal to 2 per hour, he has given. And service time, sigma is equal to half hour, that is 0.5 hour. So we know the formula in the same problem, last problem we have used, that is the long run average number of customers in the system is given by L is equal to rho plus rho square into 1 plus sigma square into mu square divided by 2, 1 minus rho. So we'll substitute whatever is given. We have all the values here. So we are substituting. The rho value is unknown. So we know rho is equal to, that is a server utilization is equal to lambda by mu. That will be 0.75. If you substitute in this, you'll get the long run time average number of customers is equal to 3.75. Similarly, the second one, long run time average number of customers in the queue, we know LQ. LQ using this formula, that is a rho square into 1 plus sigma square mu square divided by 2 into 1 minus rho. If you substitute the values, we'll get 2.25 customers. And the last one being is long run average time spent in the queue per customer. Average time spent in the queue per customer is this formula. Already we have stated this formula, so we are using it. So if you substitute the the appropriate values, we'll get 1.5 time units. Okay, let us see the third problem. It's interesting one. The third problem is like this. There are two workers competing for a job. Abel claims an average service time that is faster than Baker. That is, the service time of Abel is faster. That means Abel serves faster than Baker. But Baker claims to be more consistent even if he is not faster. That is the thing given. Abel is faster, but comparatively Baker is more consistent according to the question. Now, the arrival process is according to the Poisson process. So whenever Poisson process is there, M/G/1 we need to consider at the rate of 2 per hour. That means what? 2 customers are arriving in 1 hour, right? So Abel service statistics are as an average service time of 24 minutes, but with the standard deviation of 20 minutes. Abel service time, Abel will take 24 minutes to serve one customer. With the standard deviation of 20 minutes. Baker service time, or the average service time, is 25 minutes. You see, Baker is taking 25 minutes and Abel is taking 24 minutes to serve. So therefore, Abel is faster as told in the question, right? So Baker is taking 25 minutes, but the standard deviation of only 2 minutes. As I said, Baker is more consistent. Its standard deviation is less than compared to the Abel's. Abel is not that much consistent compared to Baker, but Abel is faster. He is taking 24 minutes and Baker is taking 25 minutes, 1 minute more. So if the average length of the queue is the criteria, that means what is the criteria? Queue length. How much is the length of the queue? So if the average length of the queue is the criteria for hiring, which worker would be hired? That means what? Depending upon the queue length, whom you will hire, whether you'll have Abel or Baker. That means what? If the queue length is more, definitely that work, because that means what? More number of customers are standing in a queue. If more numbers of customers are standing in a queue, that means what? You'll not prefer that server. Is it right? So let us see. Who will be hired if you find out the average length of the queue. whosoever the queue is more, so we'll not prefer that worker. So we'll write down what is given. Arrival is first of all according to the Poisson process, and arrival rate is equal to 2 per hour. That means what? One customers arrive for every half an hour. That means two customers are arriving in hour. 1 hour means what? One customer is arriving in half an hour, right? That means what? Lambda is equal to 1 by 30 per minute. I have converted this into minute. That means what? One customer is arrive for every 30 minutes. This is for same. Because this is arrival rate. Arrival rate is common for arrival and baker. Service rate differs, right? So what is arrival rate? Lambda is equal to 1 by 30. Lambda is equal to 1 by 30. I have divided two into two separate columns. One for arrival, another for baker. So that I can, after doing, after finding the LQ, that is average length of the queue, I can select whichever the customer I want, depending upon the length of the queue, right? So average service time of Able, we know 1 by mu is equal to 24 minutes given in the question. Whereas the average service time of Able is baker. This is baker, sorry. I made a mistake here. It is baker. The average service time of baker is equal to 1 by mu, that is equal to 25 minutes. Standard deviation is equal to 20 minutes, therefore sigma square is equal to 20 square minutes into minute square, that is 40 minutes square. Similarly, here it is only 4 minutes square. So long run time, number of customers in the queue, we know the formula. The formula is simple. LQ is equal to lambda square into 1 by mu square plus sigma square divided by 2 into 1 minus rho. So first rho, that is server utilization, we don't know. We'll find out what is server utilization. That is rho is equal to lambda by mu. So lambda we know 1 by 30. Mu is equal to actually 1 by 24. So as it is in the denominator, it is there, so it will go to numerator, that is 24. So the rho what value we are getting is 4 by 5. So if you substitute in this, LQ for Able will be getting 2.711 customers. That means what? 2.711 customers are standing in the queue on an average, right? Similarly, if you substitute the values for baker, we'll be getting 2.097 customers. You see, the number of customers standing in a queue is more for Able rather than for baker. So in this situation, no doubt we specified that Able was faster than baker, but you see the number of customers standing in the queue where Able is serving is more, right? The number of customers standing in a queue where Able is serving are more. Therefore, if the number of customers standing in a queue are more, that server we don't prefer. So that means what? Here 2.097 will prefer baker. So that's what I given the conclusion here. Although working faster on an average, Able's greater service variability results in an average queue length 30% greater than the baker. You see, this is 30% greater than this. On this basis, average queue length, LQ wins, LQ, baker wins. Because baker's number of customers standing in a queue are less than Able's number of customers standing in a queue, right? So therefore, baker is the winner. So now let us see the steady state parameters of M slash M slash 1Q. So we need to remember these formulas, we need to remember these parameters. There is no other option for M slash 1. 1 refers to what? The number of servers being 1. And Markoing, according to the Markoing model, the arrival rate, arrival inter-arrival characteristics and the service times are are specified here. That is M slash 1. So these are the different parameters. That is rho is equal to lambda by mu, server utilization, L is the length of number of customers standing in a system, LQ number of customers standing in a queue, W is the long run time spent in the system per customer, WQ is the long run time spent in the system in the queue per system per customer. This is for queue, this is for system. WQ is refers to here, queue here. PN is nothing but 1 minus lambda by mu into lambda by mu whole to the power of n, which is nothing but the steady state probability of n customers. So based on this steady state parameters, we'll solve one problem so that it becomes easy for us to remember these formulas and understand what exactly and how exactly these formulas can be used. So let us see the problem. Suppose that the inter-arrival times and service times at a single chair unisex hair styling shop have been shown to be exponentially distributed. So now the distribution is exponential here. The values of lambda and mu are 2 per hour and 3 per hour respectively. Right, and also exponentially distributed. They are also this lambda and mu are also both are exponentially distributed. Now we need to compute 6 things. First one is server utilization. Second one is probabilities of 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4 customers in the shop. Probability that the hairstylist is busy and idle. Time average number of customers in the system. Average time an arrival spends in the system. Arrival means what? A customer spends. Whoever has arrived, customer. Arrival is nothing but the customer. Average time the customer spends in the queue, average number in the queue. So this is a very straightforward question. To solve all these things, we need to remember this formula. For example, for server utilization, this is a formula. For probabilities for 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, for these probabilities, we require this formula. P of n will become P of 0, P of 1, P of 2, P of 3, and P of 4 for 4 customers. If we use this, we will get that. The third one, probability that the hairstyle is busy or idle. So we look at this. So given arrival rate is equal to 2 power r, that is 1 customer arrives for every half an hour, right? Because if 2 customers are arriving in 1 hour, for every half an hour, 1 customer is arriving. That is quite common. That is for every 30 minutes, 1 customer is arriving. That is arrival rate. Service time, what is the service time taken by the server? It is 3 per hour. That means what? The server is serving 3 customers per hour. That means what? The server is solving the problem or serving for 3 customers. He is completing the work of 3 customers. That is 3 customers are served in 1 hour. That is the service rate for 1 customer is 20 minutes. On average, if you take 1 customer is taking 20 minutes to complete its service by the server. Okay. What is the first thing is asked? Server utilization, we know the server utilization formula is rho is equal to lambda by mu. So directly rho we know and mu we know, we substitute, we will get back the server utilization, that is 2 by 3. Right, similarly probability for the customer is given by, we know the formula, this is the formula. Probability of the customer, yeah, here, this one, final formula is this one, 1 minus rho into rho to the power of n. So this is a important point here, because he's asking probability for 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 customers, right? For the 0th customer, n will be replaced with 0. Just directly use this formula and replace n with 0. If you substitute, we'll get the probability of 0th customer is 1 by 3. Similarly, for the first customer, again, I have written down the same formula which is there here. So now I will write it as 1 in place of n. P of 1 is equal to 1 minus rho into P to the power of n. Sorry, into rho to the power of n. So what is the rho value we got? What is the rho value we got? That is 2 by 3. 2 by 3 to the power of 1. So similarly, 1 minus rho, you can see this P to the power of 0 is 1. So this value itself is 1 minus rho. That is 1 by 3 itself is 1 minus rho. So 1 minus rho, I can write it as 1 minus 3, which is nothing but P naught actually. What is the P naught value I got? 1 by 3, which is same as 1 minus rho. Why it is same as 1 minus rho? Rho to the power of 0 is 1. This entire value is 1 itself, right? So P naught is actually 1 minus rho here. So wherever 1 minus rho is there, I can write P naught value, that is 1 by 3. So P1 is equal to 1 by 3. This entire value is 1 by 3. So I'll get similarly for the second customer, third customer, fourth customer, whatever it is. So after calculating the third customer probability for three customers, the last customer probability is given, you need to remember this by another formula, that is P of n plus 1. This is the last probability for the last customer. If it is last customer is 4, so n plus 1 will become 4. So n will become 3. So for the fourth customer, P of n plus 1 is equal to 1 minus summation from 0 to n into P of n, which is nothing but P of 4 is equal to 1 minus 0 to 3, because fourth customer is the last one, that is n plus 1 is the fourth customer. N is will be 3, 0 to 3. So 1 minus, is you see here minus n is there. So minus of summation I am writing down. What is that? When I value is 0, that is P0. P0, what value we got? 1 by 3 here. P0 value is 1 by 3. Plus next P1 value is 2 by 3, what we got. P2 value is 4 by 7. P3 value is this one. So I will multiply this minus sign here. So I will get down all these values. So the final value of the fourth customer is, that probability of the fourth customer is 16 by 81. So it's quite common here. Very simple. The second point is over. And what is the third thing he's asking? He's asking third thing, probability that the hairstylist is busy or and idle, both. So the probability that the hairstylist is busy is given by 1 minus P naught. Okay. 1 minus P naught, which is equal to what? The probability is given by 1 minus P0. The P0 value, how much we got? The P0 value, what we got is 1 by 3. So 1 minus 1 by 3. 1 second. 1 minus 1 by 3, what we'll be getting is 2 by 3. So this is 2 by 3 is nothing but 0.67, which is nothing but the rho itself. 1 minus P0 is rho value, what we got here. So if you want, you can write this rho or not directly, but you can write 1 minus P0, that is 2 by 3. 0.67 is the probability that the hairstyle is idle. Sorry, is the probability that the hairstyle is busy. So probability is given for 1. If 0.67 is the probability that the hairstyle is busy, then if I subtract 0.67 from 1, I will get the probability that the hairstyle is idle, because the total probability is 1. The fourth thing what is asking is,
the time average number of customers in the system given by, so what is the formula here? The time average number of the customers here, it is given by L is equal to either this or this, whichever is visible, available with us. So the fourth one, the time average number of the customers in the system is L is equal to lambda by mu minus lambda. So if you get two customers are there and an average in the system. So average time of arrival, that is a customer I have written in bracket, who spends in the system, that is W is equal to 1 by mu into mu minus lambda. This is the formula what I have taken, this one, right? So if I substitute that, I will getting 1 by 3 minus 2, that is this is 1, 1 by 1 is 1 R. So average time the customer spends in the queue, WQ is equal to the same formula what I have mentioned there. Here it is WQ formula, this one, this formula. So if I use that formula, so WQ is very quite common. So 2 by 3 we will get. So time average number in the queue, LQ is equal to this one. So that is 4 by 3 customers what we have got. So all the 7 parameters we can able to solve using these formulas. Only the extra thing here was idle and busy. That is 1 minus P naught. That is the new thing what which is not there in the table above. So if you remember this, you can very easily able to solve the above problem. So we'll see the next topic, that is a multi-server queue. So multi-server queue, there is a lot of servers, that is multi-servers, and how the queue will be, how the system will be working. Suppose that there are C channels operating in parallel. C channels in the sense is C servers actually. Channels are also there, queues are also there, C queues are there, because there are C servers, right? C number of servers. Each of these channels has an independent and identical exponential service time distribution with mean 1 by mu. And the arrival process is Poisson and the rate is lambda. Arrival will join a single queue and enter the first available service channel. So as there are a lot of servers, parallel servers, each server will have its own queue. So whenever the customer arrives or any entity arrives, it will go and join the first available queue, available server. That's what it is depicted in the diagram. Calling population will be coming, there will be waiting lines. So it can join any number, any server queue. So multi-server queuing system. So what are the steady state parameters of this m/m/c queue? So here it is infinity, infinity. What is this infinity, infinity? The number of potential customers and the number of customers in the queue are all infinity. So here C means what? C refers to the parallel number of servers, C. So we need to remember these parameters. So that is the steady state parameters of m/m/q. There is no other option for us to apart from knowing and remembering this. So these are the things. Rho is equal to lambda by C mu. P naught is equal to summation of all 0 to C. C is equal to 1. Summation of lambda by mu divided by n factorial to the power of n here. Lambda by mu to the power of C. 1 by C naught. C factorial. C mu by divided by C mu minus lambda. Inverse. Right. So this can also be written like this. So similarly, L will be this formula and LQ is this formula. W is equal to L by lambda. WQ is equal to lambda W minus. You already know all the symbols, right? Probability, number of customers in the system, number of customers in the queue, average time, waiting time, average time spent in the system per customer, average time spent in the system per customer in the queue. All these things are known. So we need to remember this because these are the steady state parameters of m/m/q. So now, whenever the number of servers is infinite, here it is parallel servers, I said many servers, but sometimes the number of servers can be infinite. So at that time, what will happen is that number of servers are infinite, that is m/c/infinity. When each customer, there are at least three situations in which this is appropriate to treat the number of servers as infinite. How can we say that the number of servers can be infinite? Normally servers will be finite, right? But sometimes the number of servers can be infinite. How can we say? Suppose if we take a shop where self-service is there, the customer has to serve himself. How many customers are coming? We don't know. We may know that we may consider it as infinity. As the customer is serving himself and there are infinite number of customers, so we can say that the servers are also infinite. Are you getting me? So in three situations, this is possible. When each customer is its own server, correct? The customer itself is serving. In other words, it's a self-service system. When server's capacity far exceeds service demand, as in a so-called ample server, when we want to know how many servers are required so that the customers will rarely be delayed. in this situation we can consider that the number of servers being infinite. So what are the steady state parameters for this? So these are the steady state parameter for this. P naught is equal to e d to the power of lambda by mu, L is equal to lambda by mu, and LQ is equal to 0, W is equal to, LQ is equal to 0, and W is equal to 1 by mu, and WQ is also 0, Pn is equal to e to the power of minus lambda by mu into lambda by mu to the power of n divided by n factorial. So last, the next topic being is steady state behavior of infinite population models. Infinite population models, which is represented as m/m/c/k/. We should remember this five character representation. M is inter-arrival times, service times, number of servers, number of customers in the system, number of potential customers in the system. All those things we should remember. This the five. Initially we discussed the five parameters, but the notations are different depending upon the different systems here. In many practical problems, the assumption of an infinite calling population leads to an invalid results because the calling population is in fact small, right? When the calling population is small, the presence of one or more customers in the system have a strong effect on the distribution of future arrivals, correct? And the use of an infinite population model can be misleading. Consider a finite calling population model with k customers. The time between the end of one service visit and the next call for the service for each member of the population is assumed to be exponentially distributed with the mean 1 by lambda time square. So these are all the characteristics of this population which we need to remember. There is no other option. Service times are also exponentially distributed with mean 1 by mu time units. There are C parallel servers and the system capacity is so that all arrivals remain for service. Such a system is shown in the figure below. So you can just check out calling population with the customers with maximum mean is 1 by mean runtime is 1 by lambda. The arrivals are coming, they're starting in queue, they are going to the parallel server, and the service of E server is 1 by mu. And after servicing, they will get departed. They will go out to the calling population again. This is a system where the customers are coming and standing in queue to the servers, which are parallel number of servers, which are servicing with the rate of 1 by mu. After get the each server gets served, the work is over, they will depart. They will go. So this is finite population queuing model, where the effective rate lambda e has several valid interpretations. Lambda e can be long run effective arrival rate of customer to queue. It can also be long run effective arrival rate of customers entering service. It can also be equivalent to long run rate at which customers exit from service, long run rate at which customers enter the calling population, long run rate at which customers exit from the calling population. So what are the steady state parameters for m/m/c/k/kqs? These are the steady state parameters which we need to remember. There is no other option, there is no other go. These are the characteristics of that system which we need to remember. So now there is a last topic, network of queues. So sometimes what happens, there is after standing, the customer standing or spending the time in a queue, after it gets served, it has to move to the next queue. For example, if you take a candy packing system, once the after the candies are prepared in the queue, then the candies will be moved to the wrapping system where the candies will be wrapped. After wrapping, it will go to the packing. That means what? The candy is moving from one queue to another queue. That means what? It's a network of queues what we are talking about, right? So many systems are naturally modeled as network of single queues in which customers departing from one queue may be routed to another queue, right? The following results assume a stable system with infinite calling population and no limit on system capacity. There is no limit and the calling population is also infinite. First one, provided that no customers are created or destroyed in the queue, then the departure rate out of a queue is the same as the arrival rate into the another queue over a long run, right? If the customers arrive to a queue I at rate lambda I, and a fraction which is the rho of ij is lesser than between 0 to 1, right? 0 is lesser than or equal to p of ij is lesser than or equal to 1 of them and rooted to the qj. Upon departure, then the arrival rate from the qi to the qj is lambda I into p of ij. These are the characteristics of the system over a long run time. The overall arrival ratio into qj is lambda j is the sum of the arrival rate from all the sources. If the customers arrive from outside the network at the rate aj, then lambda j is equal to aj plus summation of all I into lambda j p of ij. If qj has cj lesser than infinity, the parallel servers each working at rate mu, then the long run utilization of each server is given by this. Rho j is equal to lambda j divided by cj into mu j. And pj is less than 1 is required for q to be stable, right? And one more thing, if for each qj arrivals from the outside the network from the Poisson process with rate aj, and if there are cj identical servers delivering exponentially distributed service times with mean 1 by mu j, then in steady state qj behaves like m slash cj, correct? The q with arrival rate, the arrival rate for at that time in these situations are lambda j is equal to aj plus summation of all I lambda j into p of ij. So this completes this module. So I hope I have completed all the modules. If any doubts are there, you can contact me and go through all the things. So these are the things what we completed: characteristics of queuing systems, these are definitions we have seen, long run measures which we have seen, average number, and then we started with 6.4.1 for m slash g slash 1, then m slash c slash infinity, then steady state behavior of infinite models, then finally network of queues. So this completes this model. Thank you one and all. Wish you all the best. Please study well. Don't waste your time.